In this demonstration, we're going to discuss event and tracker maintenance in the latest version of DHIS2. If I've recently upgraded DHIS2 to version 2.29, I will see that I can no longer find the previous program's app. In 2.28 and below, there was a previous app that we used to manage event and tracker programs. This has since been moved to the maintenance section of DHIS2. If I go to maintenance instead, I will see a section for programs. Within this section of maintenance, I can now manage both event and tracker programs. If I click on the list view, I can see I can now add both event and tracker programs. In the previous version of DHIS2, we defined this a little bit differently. In the previous programs app, we would have to select the type of program that we are working with, either with registration or without registration. This has now been replaced in the latest version of DHIS2 by using the terminologies event and tracker program. We can see that reflected here when we go to add a new program within this new interface. If we select event programs, we can similarly see that the interface has changed quite a bit from the previous versions of DHIS2. In the previous versions of DHIS2, we would have to add in details for the program and then subsequently add in our data elements, create our sections, assign them to organization units, add in notifications, all within different parts of the application. We could assign programs to organization units from the program management screen, but then we would have to edit our sections, design our data entry form, and add notifications from the program stage management screen. This is also where we would add our data elements. Sometimes we would have to go back and forth between the program stage management screen and the program management screen in order to get our program correct. In the latest version of DHIS2, this has all been streamlined so we can do all of these operations on the same screen. We can add in our program details, assign our data elements to the program, create our data entry form if it happens to be a section or custom form that we need to create, assign the program to various organization units, and create our program notifications. It is now easier to change between the different elements that make up our program, as we no longer need to navigate to different components within the application in order to edit our event program. If you want to have a look at the event program module in maintenance, you can go ahead and view this on the demo available at play.dhis2.org. We'll make sure to put the link in the description of the video. In the second part of this video, we're going to look at changes that have been made to managing tracker programs. We're going to use an already existing tracker program in order to look at the differences between previous versions of DHIS2 and what has now been implemented in 2.29. If we select the TV program, we can see that the interface has been updated and looks similar to that which we use to manage events. We can also see at the top that there is a stepwise approach to adding in various elements that belong to our tracker program. The process for managing tracker programs has been streamlined, similar to managing events. In the previous versions of DHIS2, when we went to manage a tracker program, we would have to move between many different areas of program management in order to add in our data elements, edit our program stages, add in our program notifications, assign the program to our organization units, and manage the program overall. You can see here when I go to edit a program in the previous versions of DHIS2, I can add in details regarding the program itself, enrollment details, as well as add in the attributes. This is largely copied in the newer version of DHIS2 in the first three steps that we see at the top. We can see here we can select program details, enrollment details, and attributes. This is similar to what we can select in the previous version of DHIS2. However, it has now been integrated as a stepwise approach. You will notice when you add attributes that there are some new fields present that we can select when we add in these attributes to the program. In particular, you will see a new box that indicates if the attribute is searchable or not. This feature will be discussed in a separate video. One of the more significant changes to managing programs in the new version of DHIS2 is how we manage program stages. In the previous version of DHIS2, we could view our program stages, but then would have to manage them in different screens. If I want to manage one program stage, I'd have to select that individual program stage in order to manage its sections, design a data entry form, edit its program notifications, and also add in the data elements associated with that particular program stage. I would then have to go back to a previous screen in order to edit the next program stage. If I wanted to add in notifications at the program level, I would have to go back to the program management screen and then edit the program and add in the notifications from there. You can see that there is a lot of going back and forth between the program management screen, management of the program stages, as well as looking at individual program stages. In 2.29, managing program stages has been streamlined significantly. We are able to manage all of our program stages without having to move to different screens. If I select one program stage, I can edit all of the details, including assigning the data elements, as well as editing the data entry form. And then without having to go to a different part of the application, I can also edit the other stages. This is quite a change from the previous version of DHIS2, where there was a lot of moving back and forth between different areas of the application in order to edit these various pieces of information. You can see I can also assign the program to organization units, and also adding notifications has been streamlined. We can now add in notifications at the program stage and the program level in the same area. We do not have to go to separate areas of the application in order to add in these notifications. You can see if I select a program stage notification, I can select from all three program stages that are within this program. I do not have to go to an individual program stage and select it prior to creating the notification. I can also create program notifications at the program level without having to go to a different area of the application. If you want to have a look at the new features associated with tracker maintenance in 2.29, please have a look at the demo. As mentioned earlier, we'll make sure to put the link in the description of the video. As there are some new features that we haven't covered in significant detail, please let us know if you have any questions about anything that we've reviewed. You can also review the documentation for further information.